Do you know how old your ears are? Put on some headphones and see how many of these sound frequencies you can hear.
If you can hear that last sound, then you're probably under 24 years old. Or to be more precise, your ears are. That's because we all start losing our hearing as we get older. But there are also plenty of everyday activities that can damage our hearing without us even realizing. And here's the thing, unless it's an infection or some excessive earwax, hearing loss is irreversible.
Here's how it happens. After traveling through the outer and middle ear, sound waves end up in the inner ear. You'll find the cochlea there, lined with all these tiny little hair cells. There's about 15,500 of them, and they convert sound frequencies into electrical signals. The signals are transmitted through the auditory nerve to the brain, which translates them into sounds. It's the little hairs we need to worry about. They're continually being exposed to sound, which can damage them. If they don't get a break, they can be destroyed, and once they're gone, they can't regenerate. We lose the ability to hear high-pitched sounds first because the hairs responsible for higher frequencies are at the base of the cochlea, and so they encounter sound waves first. This means they go through more stress compared to other hairs, so they're the first to go if any damage occurs. Siobhan McGinnity is a musician, and she's doing a PhD on hearing damage in the music industry. But her insight ironically goes further than that.
Irony is 100% the key word. It's so bizarre that I'm researching, working in this area, run a non-for-profit in this area, I'm a musician, and the month of my debut EP release, I woke up deaf.
Siobhan was diagnosed with an inner ear disorder called Meniere's disease. For her, it means she has fluctuating hearing and vertigo.
I really struggled in cafes and in restaurants and in social settings where we were at a pub. And all of a sudden, you know, even this small amount of hearing loss, I was like, wow, I'm actually incredibly isolated. And so it was a real eye-opener to what it really means to be so socially removed from our world.
About 1 in 6 of us suffer some degree of hearing loss. It sounds like this. Take this clip of Dr. Carl.
It's a lovely experience to walk on the beach, and it can be made even lovelier by finding a large empty seashell and putting it to your ear.
Now, this is what that same clip would sound like to someone with noise-induced hearing loss.
It's a lovely experience to walk on the beach, and it can be made even lovelier by finding a large empty seashell and putting it to your ear.
And here's what it would be like if you had tinnitus.
It's a lovely experience to walk on the beach, and it can be made even lovelier by finding a large empty seashell and putting it to your ear.
Most of us have experienced tinnitus. It's that ringing or buzzing sound you'll hear after being exposed to loud noises, and it's an early sign of hearing loss. So what's considered too loud?
Sound level is measured in decibels. Anything under 85 decibels is unlikely to cause hearing loss, even over an extended period of time. But any sounds at or above 85 decibels could. It's equivalent to the sound of heavy city traffic.
And the decibel scale itself can be a bit confusing, but basically when you turn the sound up 3 decibels, you're actually doubling the intensity.
So when we talk about from a hearing conservation perspective, there's actually this numerical rule that we go by, and it's 85 dB A for 8 hours a day. And if you got 3 dB, and you double to your intensity to 88, and we recommend halving how long you listen to it. So 88 for 4 hours, 91 for 2 hours, and so on.
Here's a good general guide. A normal conversation is about 60 to 65 decibels, totally safe. A lawnmower can be about 90 to 95 decibels, so as long as you're not mowing for hours, you're fine. Headphones are all different, but they can generally produce at least 103 decibels at max volume, and a concert or sporting event can be about 110 decibels. And something like fireworks, that's about 140 decibels and above. Immediate damage.
If you're now thinking about all the times that you've put your ears at risk, then don't be too worried. There are some really simple things you can do to help minimise your risk. One of the easiest things you can do is just to give your ears a break every now and then.
I like to think of it like any other part of my body gets tired when I overwork it, and your ears are exactly the same.
If you're constantly surrounded by loud sounds, earplugs are a good investment. You can get special custom earplugs that lower the volume but not the quality.
At some time in adulthood, you make friends with salad. It's exactly the same thing. If you want to keep using your hearing and you're working in loud environments, you're just going to have to make friends with earplugs at some stage, and that is okay.
If you use earphones or headphones a lot, you can change the volume limit so you can't accidentally go too loud. Around 70 to 80% is a good cutoff point. Or you could invest in some noise-cancelling headsets, which help drown out ambient noise, so you're not turning up the volume as high. If you're curious about how loud your surroundings are, there's heaps of free sound meter apps you can download.
But if you're really worried something is wrong, go see an audiologist and get your hearing professionally tested.
I guess it sounds cliche, but you don't realise your privilege until it's taken away. Your hearing and your ability to hear is privilege. Don't take it for granted.
If you want to check out more resources, we've popped some links down below to the HearSmart website and the Know Your Noise website. They go into heaps more detail about hearing loss and ways you can look after your ears.